Here's what's new in mapping and visualization in ArcGIS Pro 2.4.
You can now identify the nearest M value for line features, export reports using geoprocessing and Model Builder, copy and paste selected cells from Excel into a table, and save and load bookmarks using a file. You can also measure volumes between a plane and a surface using the exploratory cut and fill tool. Use profile viewing to help edit LiDAR class codes and display building cross sections. And render 3D vector polygons with an animated water fill symbol. Ambient occlusion has been added to lighting in 3D to make it easier to understand the shape and position of features in a scene. This is especially helpful when using untextured or thematic data like these building shapes. The calculations in the elevation mesh have been tightened and terrain skirts removed, allowing you to see through the terrain mesh from above or below. You can now disable lighting effects on a layer, for instance, if you have a multi-patch which already has shading captured from imagery. Idome lighting has also been added to point cloud and last dataset layers to allow better understanding of where individual points are in the cloud. Using this option, you can better understand both the shape of the data and the attribution captured in the point cloud. Markers in the newly supported GLTF format have material properties such as shininess, metallic textures, and roughness that will respond realistically to light. Normal mapping and occlusion mapping in GLTF are also supported, allowing for a larger degree of detail and realism in your scenes.
With feature binning, you could dynamically aggregate point features into regular shaped bins with different statistical results. This allows you to explore and visualize large datasets to see patterns at micro and macro levels. As you zoom in, you discover a pattern in greater detail. Once you zoom beyond a threshold scale, you will see individual features. You could even set a definition query and make it time aware. To get started with feature binning, run the Enable Feature Binning Geoprocessing tool.
Symbol effects have now been improved. Note this offset effect here is used to achieve a waterline symbolization, where multiple strokes have different offsets. It draws quickly and with high quality. Tree styles have also been improved to draw better at higher LODs. An orange tree model has also been added. Custom dictionary symbology is also now supported. I can add a custom dictionary, as I've already done here, and change custom aspects of its symbolization. For instance, draw the flag instead of an abbreviation.
We now have the ability to add background highlighting to text. On this airport map, we can see the background used for the airport signs. This is done using the new BGD tag. This label expression uses a significant amount of logic and formatting. The full expression can be found in the airport signs help topic and can be copied and pasted directly into ArcGIS Pro. All dialogs are now resizable. In the priority dialog, the unlabeled label classes now display as gray and items can be dragged and dropped into different locations. When converting labels to annotation, you can now convert individual layers as well as the entire map. And when you convert labels from multiple layers, you can now merge the annotation into one feature class and merge label classes that have the same name and properties.
We've introduced new ways to visualize and explore temporal data. With the new calendar heat chart, you can summarize your incident data into a calendar grid. You can also aggregate your temporal data into a year grid to show how patterns fluctuate by month and the day of the month, or into a week grid that will reveal which days of the week and times of the day experience the most activity. And for both data clocks and calendar heat charts, you can now set manual class breaks, giving you full control over your legend.
In page layouts, map series can be clipped to the index feature. Grids can also be clipped and now include a new component, interior ticks. The map frame and table sources for a table frame can be updated, allowing you to change the data displayed without losing your formatting. Also, you can now copy page layouts across multiple instances of ArcGIS Pro.
Python developers now have fine-grained access to the SIM, Esri's cartographic information model, and therefore have access to so many more properties and settings. The SIM is a map content specification used to persist and transfer cartographic descriptions of GIS datasets and is persisted as JSON. The SIM object model is identical to how the objects are navigated in the Python API. This example demonstrates access to symbology properties currently not exposed to the manage ArcPy.mp module. Here's what's new in analysis in ArcGIS Pro 2.4.
New with this release are GeoAnalytics desktop tools. These tools can aggregate and summarize data, analyze patterns, and perform feature and table analysis on large datasets. They use Apache Spark to parallelize the processing using all of your desktop CPU cores and memory for faster analysis. Here we're going to aggregate 5 million points into 100 neighborhood polygons using a one-day time step. This will complete in under 20 seconds, while standard spatial join can take several minutes. And since the analysis included the time step, we can use the time slider to step through the results one day at a time.
We've added a new way to automate your geoprocessing work using the geoprocessing history. Previously, you could copy the Python command to run the tool with the same parameters, or send the command to the Python window. Now you can also save your history as a Python script to run outside of ArcGIS Pro, or make a custom script tool. We've also enhanced the surface analysis tools to allow you to select local and surface-based elevation surfaces from your 3D scene. When you select an elevation surface, the value transforms into the data source of the elevation surface.
It's easier than ever to create a complete connected geoprocessing model from tools you've previously run. You can drag and drop tools from the geoprocessing history into an existing model. The tool input and output datasets are analyzed to determine connections, producing an optimized diagram that represents the sequence of tools you ran. There are two new commands to export from Model Builder to Python code. You can export to a Python file or send the code to the Python window for immediate review and execution. Each tool in the model is included in the Python code. Model iterators and logical tools are not supported this release.
By default, the 3D Analyst profile graph shows entire lines in the graph regardless of the current map extent. And now you can click the New Extent button on the profile graph to graph just those portions of lines that appear in the current map extent. Another enhancement at this release is with the LAS Building Rooftop Classifier, which can now produce higher quality results while also being faster and less sensitive to variations in point density.
We've added new tools to analyze transit networks. Transit authorities share information about bus routes and stops in a data format called GTFS, or General Transit Feed Specification. You can download this type of data and use geoprocessing tools like the new GTFS to Transit Network Sources tool to create a network dataset that supports the transit evaluator. For example, this service area shows what is accessible in 30 minutes at 7:15 a.m. Now, if we change the time to 8:15 a.m., new bus service is available and more area is accessible.
The new Build Balance Zones tool allows partitioning data into even zones with respect to user-defined criteria. You can also define secondary constraints to defined zones, such as preserving global ratios of a categorical variable in each zone. The Local Bivariate Relationships tool explores spatial relationships between two variables and maps statistically related areas and visualizes relationships. Forest-based classification and regression now allows assessing prediction uncertainty and plotting distribution of variable importance.
Statistical data collections now support custom calculations, and you can share your custom data to your organization's portal. A new interactive business and facilities search allows you to quickly locate competitors. In territory design, you could build territories based on street network distance and use barriers to exclude areas. And finally, the Business Analyst Toolbox now contains new tools, such as Huff Model and Drive Time Trade Areas. All Euclidean tools in the Distance toolset now support barriers. Here, the Euclidean distance between the feeding sites and the nest of a seahawk is calculated using coastline as a barrier. We can now use the cost path as polyline tool to get a smooth path.
Here's what's new in data management in ArcGIS Pro 2.4. We are proud to announce the release of the Parcel Fabric with ArcGIS Pro 2.4. Editing can be done on the file geodatabase or now on data published to portal, allowing multi-user editing with branch versioning. You can upgrade your ArcMap parcel fabric or easily migrate existing data into the fabric. The footprint of every legal record is now maintained within the record feature class. When performing record-driven workflows, you can use any edit tool like merge, clip, or traverse. In this merge example, historic parcels are created and parcel lineage is defined.
ArcGIS Pro 2.4 includes the offset tool for creating features offset from lines at varying distances. We can trace along this road center line, enter the starting station distance, the end station distance, change the feature template, enter stations and offsets from a document, and then create the features. The sequential numbering tool allows you to attribute point, line, or polygon features with incrementing values. For text fields, you can format the incrementing value with additional text. Last release, we introduced contingent values for attribute fields. Now you can export these to a CSV file, allowing you to make changes to them outside of ArcGIS Pro, in Microsoft Excel, for example. We've also enhanced our support of Microsoft Excel files. We've cleaned up the display of titles and column headers and improved how international and special characters are handled. And you can now use the GeoDatabase Administration dialog box to view locks associated with branch versions. There are new columns and filter options, and if you have administrative privileges, you can also disconnect locks.
When using extract locations, you can create templates to quickly utilize different properties and methods when extracting coordinates and text for different sets of documents or text. You can also create and edit custom attributes. This allows you to target and extract critical pieces of text from documents. The data is saved in the output attribute table. You can also configure custom locations matching keywords to geographic coordinates. In this case, we'll ensure that the Lexington Market is associated with the correct coordinates in our output.
We've introduced related properties, which allow organizations to add their own one-to-many job properties. In this scenario, the green survey areas are too small to track individually, so we can group them into three jobs and track their status using related properties. We can also incorporate other information tables with one-to-many joins and add, update, or delete records. And once each green survey area is processed, we can update its status in related properties on the job.
We've added pixel editing capabilities to the Image Analyst extension. The pixel editor can reclassify thematic data one pixel at a time or a whole region at a time. You can also replace regions of pixels to repair artifacts. For example, you can replace a cloudy area with an area without clouds. Elevation can be edited to smooth an area or even remove terrain. With the volume tool in the mensuration gallery, you can measure the volume of objects in a digital surface model or digital terrain model. The new Image Support Data Properties page provides quick and intuitive access to detailed information on NITF files. You can dynamically search through image support data and export it too. We've added the ability to create and share a deep learning package locally or to your portal to perform raster analytics using deep learning tools.
We added new raster functions to support many workflows, like creating flow length, and the new multidimensional analysis tools can calculate statistics and anomalies.
You can now process Red Edge and Altum images using orthomapping drone workflow to produce orthomosaics and various index maps. Using a combination of the enhanced cloud raster format, new geoprocessing tools, extended raster functions, and the ArcPy API, you can now analyze multidimensional scientific data faster and easier than ever.
Here's what else is new in the rest of the application at ArcGIS Pro 2.4. Now you can publish and overwrite services to a standalone ArcGIS server from within ArcGIS Pro. Here we're publishing a map service and a feature service, which are immediately available to users connected to the server. We've also added new options for sharing and downloading content. Here, we've left the default location for package downloads, but we'll change the location for other files. So now, the tile layer included with the map package is saved in the project's home folder by default. At 2.4, vector tile layers can be replaced without changing the URL or item ID using the Replace Web Layer tool. This allows a seamless experience for anyone currently using the layer.
By choosing Download Map, you can now download vector tile layers, including base maps. A local copy of each layer is created in your project, matching the extent of the current map view, which will persist when you're working offline.
We now have the ability to convert the S57 vector product for storing nautical charting data to the new vector S11 format. We could also modify and input point or multipoint feature classes using the Reduce Point Density tool, and smooth triangulated irregular network, or TIN, datasets using the Smooth Bathymetric TIN tool.
The Pro SDK now includes a newly enhanced scene layer API. You can now access each of the different scene layer types, updating them with filters and filter blocks, queries, selections, and symbology. This release also includes a new Stream Layer API and enhancements to the map authoring, geometry, and content APIs. There's also SIM and NuGet enhancements, as well as new support for Visual Studio 2019.
With real-time API, you can now perform analysis with real-time data. For example, you can find the coffee shops within 100 meters, perform viewshed analysis as you drive along, or send alerts as vehicles enter a restricted zone. Pro SDK allows you to integrate real-time analysis with the rest of the ecosystem.